Hey everybody, this is Dana, and welcome to the trailer for the Tarot School video series. This video series will teach you how to read the tarot. Absolutely, positively will. I am going to take you from the initial setup, what you need, what your table needs to include, what kind of cards you need to get, what kind of environment that you need to surround yourself in. And then we're going to dive into the major arcana, an in-depth explanation of each and every card in the major arcana. But it's not just a rote card after card after card explanation. I'm going to explain to you why the major arcana is entitled The Major Mysteries of Life. That's what arcana means. Arcana means mysteries. And I'm going to explain to you why the major arcana, all 22 cards, why the major arcana is so crucially important and how to interpret it in a reading when the major arcana comes through. I'm going to take you through the major arcana from an organizational perspective so you can understand the path that's being presented in a tarot card reading when these cards come up. Then we're going to move on to the earth energy, the water energy, the fire energy, and the air energy. And we're going to do an in-depth explanation of all of the minor arcana, just like we do the major arcana. This is an intro 101 course, okay? Our objective and our goal here is to simply internalize and understand the tarot. This internalization will be accomplished by not only an auditory and a visual experience, but a tactile experience as well with what I'm calling cheat sheets. There's a cheat sheet for the major arcana, all four suits of the minor arcana, and numerology that gives you the root definitions. I encourage you through this entire video series to scribble all over these cheat sheets, write notes, write things that are meaningful to you about each card to help you even further internalize the meaning of the tarot. I'm not going to go into planetary placements and astrological assignments because, quite frankly, I'm not an astrologer, and that has absolutely zero bearing on my psychic ability in a tarot card reading, okay? Now, we will explore that in Module 2 because it's an extremely important part of what the tarot is and why the tarot is the tarot. But as far as being able to do a psychic intuitive reading using your giftings with the tarot, it's absolutely positively, in my professional opinion, not a necessary aspect of understanding the tarot. When you're finished with this Module 1 of Tarot School, when you go through all of the videos, you will be able to interpret and read a tarot card reading. Now, that being said, if you are not familiar with my style, I read tarot very, very differently than a lot of people read tarot. So go to Deep Thoughts with Dana on YouTube and go see how it is that I read the cards, because by watching me read the cards, you will understand how I'm going to teach you to read the cards, okay? So how I read them is how I'm going to teach you to read them, and I want you to be absolutely comfortable with the way that I interpret the cards and the way that I explain the cards in a reading, because I want you to be happy with Tarot School, right? I don't want you to order any of these videos and then go, ugh, really? So go watch the way that I read, and that will help you to decide whether you want to invest your time and effort into this series that I've produced, okay? So do that. All right. I also want to point out that I can't teach you the psychic gifting. I can't. Now, the cards will procure your psychic gifting, but as far as teaching you the psychic gifting, I cannot do that. That is something that is intrinsic that you have to have within yourself in order to be able to read the cards. Now, I want to explain something to you. My goal is to demystify the tarot cards. That's the goal, is to demystify the tarot cards. There is an algorithm and a pattern that needs to be understood to be able to understand what the cards are saying. Can you read tarot cards without a psychic gifting? Yes, you can. You can read them logically without the psychic gifting, okay? You can read the cards from a logical perspective because there is an algorithm that goes through the cards that I'm going to teach you. But the psychic gifting is what allows you to sew the story together. It's what allows you to connect with your client or whoever it is that you're reading the cards for. It allows you to see the bigger picture, right? To make the cards meaningful in a tarot card reading. Can you read them without the gifting? Yes, you can. You can interpret them logically and follow the algorithm and know what the cards are saying. Can you apply it? I don't think so. I don't think you can apply a tarot card reading without a psychic gifting. So that being said, I can't teach you that. But if you feel like you have something like that, a little inkling, a little fire of something like that, working with the tarot cards, it will explode all over the place. It will explode. It's almost like training for your psychic abilities. So all of that being said, this is Tarot School, and this is the video series. My job here is to demystify the tarot and help you to understand how to do a tarot card reading from a very logical perspective, and applying your psychic abilities to the logic is what's going to produce an amazing tarot card reading. So go watch me on YouTube, Deep Thoughts with Dana. See if you like the way that I read. If you want to learn to read that way, by all means, come on back. You can purchase this entire series, or you can just purchase a couple videos every now and then, right? You do what works for you. There's a place for everybody in this teaching series. I do hope you enjoy it. Namaste.